And welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we will discuss reaction of metal
with the
water. Reaction of metal
with the
water. Reaction of metal with water is dependent on reactivity of metals. High reactive metals like sodium, potassium, calcium, they react with cold water. The metals like magnesium, they react with hot water. And less reactive metals like aluminium, zinc, iron, they react with steam. So what we have cold water, hot water, and steam. Cold water, hot water, and steam. The high reactive metals like sodium, potassium, and calcium, they react with the cold water. The reaction will be if we add a piece of sodium in a cold water. As we know, sodium is a reactive metal, it reacts vigorously with the water, and what will happen? It will form this. Hydroxide and hydrogen gas is released, but this reaction is highly exothermic. A large amount of energy, is released, and this released energy is sufficient to ignite the hydrogen gas. Hydrogen gas burns here, it catches fire. So what will you observe when a piece of sodium is added in a water? First, will you say sodium hydroxide is formed? Second, sodium starts floating on the surface. Third, the released gas is hydrogen, and due to exothermic nature, this gas catches fire. You will see fire on a surface, right? Similarly, potassium react very rapidly, very quickly with hot water, and large amount of energy is released. Reaction will be potassium plus water to give potassium hydroxide plus hydrogen plus energy. Again, this energy is sufficient to ignite hydrogen. Here again, hydrogen gas burns, it catches fire. But in case of calcium, calcium hydroxide is formed and hydrogen gas is released. But in this reaction, less energy is released. So less energy is not sufficient to ignite the hydrogen gas. Hydrogen gas here will not burn. Only less amount of energy is released. Why it is happening? Because of reactivity. As we know, potassium is more reactive calcium. So reactive metals like sodium, potassium, calcium, they react with cold water, they form the hydroxide correspondingly, and hydrogen gas is released. In case of sodium and potassium, hydrogen gas catches fire, but in case of calcium, hydrogen gas does not catches fire, right? And bubbles of hydrogen gas are formed, and these bubbles stick with the calcium metal, calcium surface. So calcium start also floating on the surface. You will see calcium metal floats on the surface. This is the reaction of active metals with the cold water, right? But the less reactive metal than these, like Magnesium will not react with cold water because of its less reactivity. It will react with the hot water. It will require certain amount of energy. So magnesium plus water, hot water, what will form? Magnesium hydroxide plus hydrogen gas is released again, right? So most of the metal reacts with cold water and hot water. They form their hydroxide. But some metals like aluminium, like iron, like zinc, they react with the steam. Steam is the water at 100 degrees Celsius. So what is the difference of reaction with the steam? Now take a look again. Aluminium, iron and zinc, they react with the steam. Instead of metal hydroxide, here we will obtain metal oxides and hydrogen gas is released again. Aluminium plus water. Water in gas is formed, so it is a steam. What will be obtained? Aluminium oxide plus hydrogen. Because of its less reactivity and water is here at 100 degrees Celsius. So instead of hydroxide, oxide is formed and hydrogen gas is released. Similarly, reaction with zinc, Zn plus H2O to form zinc oxide and hydrogen gas is released again. Similarly, iron, zinc, aluminium, they will not react with cold water and hot water. They will react with steam only. Steam means water at 100 degrees Celsius. So we will obtain again its oxide plus. You may write both type of oxides. Fe2O3 plus H2. Right. So basically what we have learned, metal reacts with water to form their hydroxides or their oxide depending on the nature of metal, means reactivity of metals. High reactive and intermediate reactive metals, they react with cold water and hot water respectively to form hydroxides. But less reactive metals, they react with water when at 100 degrees Celsius, means water must be in a gaseous state, they will form their oxides. So basic format is metal plus water. Metal plus water to form metal hydroxide plus hydrogen. And if they are less reactive metals, they will form water but in a gaseous form. They will form metal oxide and hydrogen gas is released again. All metal react with water to form to give hydrogen gas. But here is a one important point: metals like copper, like silver, like gold, like platinum, means least reactive metal, least reactive metals never react with the water, either steam, no reaction. That's why again jewelry is made up of silver and gold, because of their inert nature with the water. They will never react with the water because of their least reactivity. They are stable, right? It is the second property, reaction of metal with the water. In next segment we will do more properties. That's it for today. And do a favor, if you still didn't subscribe my channel, subscribe. Thank you.